Good morning, everyone. Today, we're going to be drawing carbohydrates, lipids, proteins, and nucleic acids. You should have already completed all of topic 2.1 and the first video on topics 2.3 and 2.4. These four boxes can be put straight into the table that you already drew. Though obviously, if they're too big for the table, feel free to just write A, B, C, and D and link them to these four. Here we're going to be doing a few drawings. Two drawings for carbohydrates, two drawings for proteins, one, two, three, four drawings for lipids, and one drawing for nucleic acids. Before we get started, there's an important thing you need to remember how to do. We are going to be dealing with four different elements: carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and hydrogen. And it is important to remember how many bonds each one always makes. You have to know that carbon will always make four bonds, nitrogen will always make three, oxygen will always make two, and hydrogen will always make one bond. A bond being a direct link to another atom in a molecule. So with that said, let's get started. We're going to start with carbohydrates today, also known as carbs and sugars. As we draw these, I've put a few rules on the side. The first one is we're always going to start with oxygen. Then we are going to build our chain of carbons from the oxygen. Glucose has six carbons and makes a hexagon shape. Hex means six. Ribose has five carbons and makes a pentagon shape. Then we will add the correct number of bonds. The oxygens will get two bonds and the carbons will get four. With that done, every atom that has a free bond will get a hydrogen. Then every atom that has a free bond will get an oxygen hydrogen. And finally, any free bonds left over, we will put a hydrogen to finish our drawing. So, take a moment now to write down these rules for the carbohydrates. And let's get started. So the first one we are going to draw right now is glucose. So, for our drawing of glucose, we will start with an oxygen. Now, remember that a glucose is going to be a hexagon shape with six carbons. So starting from the oxygen, one, two, three, four, five, six. So note that I have made a hexagon shape, but that this hexagon has a tail. That is really important. So my zero, one, two, three, four, five, six to make glucose. With that done, we will now add the correct number of bonds. Oxygen has two. So oxygen is now full. It has the two bonds it will ever have. Now all these carbons need four. This one has two, so we will add two more. This is true of every carbon inside the chain. So I'm adding two bonds to each carbon. This one already has one, two, three, so just one more. And this carbon only has one, so one, two, three. Now, all of these have the right number of bonds. So every free atom, we will add one hydrogen. So I'm going through and adding hydrogens to every free atom on the molecule. Now we will do the same with oxygen hydrogens. This is called a hydroxide group. You will never really see this used in biology, but if you take chemistry, you need to know that OH is a hydroxide. So you can either draw it as OH or do what I'm doing and actually do this oxygen with two bonds and a hydrogen with one. This carbon is already full. Okay, at this point, we only have one bond left. So we will finish the molecule with a hydrogen. And this is our drawing of glucose. So now, let's do the same thing for ribose, and I will do it a little bit smaller down here. The same rules will apply. We start with an oxygen, but this time we make a pentagon shape because there are five carbons. So here is my pentagon. I will put the right number of bonds. This one only has one, and this one has three. I will add an H to every carbon. Then an OH. And finish the molecule with an H. So this is our drawing of ribose, and this is our drawing of glucose. We've done both the drawings you need to know. Here, do not draw what I'm about to draw, but note that this really is a hexagonal shape, whereas this one is a pentagon. Later, when you are, if you are higher level, we will start to refer to the numbers of the carbons in the chain. So especially talking about ribose, we have zero, and then carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Do not draw the stuff in red or purple right now. That is more than you need to know. These are the two carbohydrates you need to know how to draw. Again, remember the correct number of bonds, start with an oxygen, then make a chain of carbons in the shape that you're looking for, a hexagon or a pentagon with a tail. Add the correct number of bonds to every atom, then fill every carbon with a hydrogen, fill every carbon with a hydroxide, and finish with an H. With that said, let's move on to lipids. Lipids are fats and oils. Now, lipids are really just long chains of carbons. If the IB ever asks you to draw a lipid, you have to draw at least five. You can draw more. The longest lipids are 20 or 30 carbons long, but you have to draw at least five. All lipids will have a CH3 on one end and end with a COOH. If you are in chemistry, this COOH is something you need to know as making an acid. So when we draw the phospholipid bilayer, you will remember that phospholipids have a phosphate head and a fatty acid tail. This is the acid. So, let's get started. Lipids. First off, they can be saturated or unsaturated. Saturated means all single bonds. So let's see what that actually means. Again, a long chain of carbons, at least five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One end will be a CH3. So here's my C, which has three H's attached. The other end is a COOH. So here we will do something funny. Remember that carbons need to do four bonds. This carbon on the end will have a double bond. So oxygen still has two bonds, but both bonds are with the same carbon. Here we have our usual OH. Just like in a carbohydrate. So here are my two ends, CH3 and COOH. Now we have three carbons in the middle. If they are all single bonds instead of a double bond, that means all my carbons will have single bonds to make 1, 2, 3, 4. And all the rest of these are hydrogens. This is a saturated lipid. Unsaturated lipids have double bonds in the chain. So what does this look like? There are three different ways that they can be unsaturated. You do not necessarily need to know how to draw all three, but you should be able to recognize them and draw whichever one I ask you to. But they all have the same basic structure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, with H's on one end, and an OOH on the other. This is true of all lipids, so these two rules are always true. But unsaturated lipids will have a double bond inside. Now, because of this double bond, note that this carbon still has only two bonds, so it can make four, but this one already has three, so it can only make one. And this one already has three, so it can only make one. So now 1, 2, 3, 4. Four bonds for carbon. So if I fill out the hydrogens here, note that this has only one hydrogen instead of two. Now let's see if you can spot the difference between a cis fatty acid and a trans fatty acid. So, like usual, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. CH3 on one end and COOH on the other. Now we will put a double bond and fill out the carbons with H's as needed. Now, can you spot the difference between a cis fatty acid and a trans fatty acid? The difference is here. A cis fatty acid has hydrogens on the same side of the double bond, while a trans fatty acid has the hydrogens on opposite sides of the double bond. So this is actually very similar to the words cissexual or transsexual. If you hear of a transsexual person, that means that they are male, but think of themselves as female, or vice versa. They are across the sexual divide. Meanwhile, a cissexual person is on the same side, a male who considers themselves male, or female who considers themselves female. So these are useful words. Trans just means across. Transportation is across different ports in the ocean. So that helps me remember which one is cis and which one is trans. So, what does poly mean? Well, a polyunsaturated fatty acid means it has many double bonds. So what does this look like? Like usual, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, with CH3 on one end and a COOH on the other. But what this means is that now there is more than one double bond inside the molecule. So this carbon has 1, 2, 3 bonds, so let's add 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. It is already full. 1, 2, 3 bonds, let's add 4. Now, polyunsaturated fatty acids can have many double bonds. Obviously, this one only has 5 carbons, but this could have 10. With different types. And thus, polyunsaturated fatty acids can be a mix of cis and trans. And that's it for lipids. So let's move on to proteins. Proteins are made of amino acids. So, an amino acid is also an acid, just like the fatty acids that lipids are made of. Because they are both acids, they will both end with a COOH. However, amino acids have an NCC backbone, not just carbons. This is the only molecule that you need to know how to draw that has a nitrogen. So if you see a nitrogen in it, it's a protein. So it will start with the nitrogen doing NH2, because nitrogens can have three bonds. And it will end with a COOH. So, an NCC as a backbone. Nitrogen makes three bonds, so we have NH2 on one end, and just like fatty acids, we have a COOH on the other. This carbon can make four bonds, and one of those bonds is always an H. The other one can be anything. There are 20 common amino acids, and you are required to know that number. Now, what makes all the amino acids different? The R group. There is no element called R. This R is just a variable that can be anything. So it could be just an H, or it could be a huge branch larger than the actual amino acid backbone. Now, in theory, you could also be asked how to draw a dipeptide. A dipeptide is two amino acids stuck together. Dipeptide. Di meaning two. So, it would still have this NCC backbone, except that now there are two of them. Like always, you have an NH2 on one end and a COOH on the other. But now we have the amino acids inside. So this nitrogen already has two bonds. So it just has one of the hydrogens. This carbon has its double bond with oxygen. Now, if you remember, here there would normally have been an OH. And here there would normally have been an H. These will bind together to make water. So here is H2O. This carbon in the middle has a hydrogen and an R group. And this carbon in the middle has a hydrogen and an R group. And this is our dipeptide, made of two amino acids. All right. Now let me talk about one tricky thing that the IB might do, because sometimes they will give you four drawings and ask you which one is a fatty acid or which one is a protein. Anything with nitrogen is a protein. If you see nitrogen, it's a protein. But remember how fatty acids are these long chains? That means that sometimes you will get confused between a fatty acid and a dipeptide because they both look like long chains. However, there's a nitrogen in this chain, so it is a protein, not a fatty acid. If they wanted to confuse you even more, this molecule could be drawn even smaller. So, I could draw it like this. 1, 2, 3. With a hydrogen on one, the three H's on one end, and the OOH on the other. Here, like usual, two hydrogens for a saturated fatty acid, but note that in my drawing I actually have two of these, so I'm just multiplying that by two. And this drawing looks very similar to this drawing. So if they try to confuse you with this, look for the nitrogen. If it has nitrogen, it's an amino acid. Okay, well, I'm glad to tell you we have done the three most complicated ones. Now we have the simplest nucleic acids left to do. And in your drawing, shapes matter. Nucleic acids are made of sugars, phosphates, and bases. And you will remember how to draw a sugar. Here is your drawing of a sugar. In DNA and RNA, the sugar is a version of ribose, which is a pentagon. That means in a nucleic acid, don't forget that I start with my zero, and then I make my pentagon chain with a tail. So the sugar is always drawn as a pentagon with a tail. This is my ribose that we have just drawn at the beginning of this video. If you remember how to draw a phospholipid that has a phosphate head, the phosphate head is a circle. So the circle attaches here. And finally, at this corner, which would be this carbon right here, we have the base attach. And the base is always a rectangle. So this is my drawing of a nucleic acid. And the drawing is actually done at this point. Now what I will say is that this up here is the phosphate. Again, the pentagon is my sugar. And my sugar can be ribose in RNA or deoxyribose in DNA. Deoxyribose is a ribose missing one oxygen, as you might guess. And RNA really just stands for ribonucleic acid, while DNA stands for deoxyribonucleic acid. Finally, we have the base, and the base can be one of five different things. It could be adenine, cytosine, guanine, or thymine, or uracil. Note that these three are DNA and RNA, whereas this one is DNA only, and uracil is in RNA only. This is the full drawing, and if they ask you to draw and label a nucleic acid of DNA, then you would have to label the sugar as deoxyribose. Sugar would be too vague. But you could still just label the base as base, because there are four options for DNA and four options for RNA. If you're asked to draw a nucleotide, which is the monomer for DNA, then a nucleotide, which is the monomer for RNA or DNA. Remember that for RNA, the sugar would be ribose. So make sure to label the sugar as ribose in RNA. The last thing I want to mention for nucleic acids is that when they form polymers in a polynucleic acid of DNA or RNA, the backbone is actually a sugar phosphate backbone. What that means is if I draw several nucleic acids, they will bond with each other. I will draw three here, between the phosphates and the sugars. So the bond will go here. And now this is three attached together, so technically a trinucleic acid. Okay, so at this point we have done all the major drawings. There is one more that they could potentially ask you, which is with lipids, specifically how to draw glycerol. Glycerol is a weird one, and glycerol only really applies sometimes. It's quite rare. But if they ever ask you to draw it, it's three carbons because of the triglyceride, and all of the carbons have one OH, and every other bond is a hydrogen. This is very rare, so don't worry too much about glycerol. So if you haven't finished drawing everything yet, draw it now. Thanks so much, and have a wonderful rest of your day. Ciao!